Good morning, everybody. Thanks for joining us here on the web. The response to Irma is massive, with help arriving from all over the country, ready to go as soon as conditions allow. But it could still be a while as we wait for things to be a little bit safer. Medics from American Medical Response in both Nashua and Manchester are on standby in Georgia right now. Meantime, dozens of employees from Asplund Tree Expert are also in the southeast to help with tree removal, and line crews from Eversource and Liberty Utilities left late last week to help restore power to millions of people in the dark.
Be 2 weeks, it could be 4 weeks, I don't know. From what I'm seeing, like I said, the damage, it looks like they're going to be gone for a good period of time, I would think.
Repopulating people back into nursing homes and hospitals once the storm has passed and those places get reopened. But essentially, we're there to do anything we can at the request of the federal government or state government to help anybody out down there.
There are, of course, many people here in New Hampshire watching the storm carefully and waiting to hear from loved ones. Katie Daniels of Rochester sent us this video taken by family members in Jupiter, Florida. As you can see, their street was already flooded yesterday afternoon. And Maria Cody sent us this picture from Venice, Florida. She and her husband just retired to Florida in February from southern New Hampshire, seeing a lot of rain and flooding there. And if you have a connection to what's going on down in Florida or the disaster in the Caribbean, we'd love to share your story with us. Message us on Facebook or send us an email to breakingnews@WMUR.com to share any images and stories of Irma. The debate over New Hampshire's new voter registration law will continue in the courts today. The State Democratic Party and the League of Women's Voters have both sued, saying that Senate Bill 3 violates the state constitution and will discourage people from voting. But the state says it simply ensures that people who vote in New Hampshire actually live here or intend to. The state will argue today that the cases should be thrown out. Flags are flying at half staff today across the state as we mark 16 years since September 11th, and there are several memorials and services. In Portsmouth, the service starts at 8:46, the time the first plane hit the World Trade Center. That service is outside of Portsmouth City Hall. And the Lincoln Fire Department is hosting a memorial stair climb at the Mountain Club on Loon starting at 9. All the proceeds go to the National Fallen Firefighters Foundation. A Berlin man is dead this morning after crashing his off-road vehicle on a trail in Jericho Mountain State Park. Fish and game officers say 65-year-old Andre Sine was riding with a group of people on Lake Loop Trail when he crashed just after 5 o'clock last night. Other members of his group started CPR right away, but he died at the scene. A 53-year-old man is dead after a motorcycle crash in Bow. Bow police say the motorcycle collided with a car on Route 3A Sunday afternoon. The passenger was taken to the hospital with non-life-threatening injuries, I should say. Police do not believe speed or alcohol were factors in this crash, but the motorcyclist was not wearing a helmet. And caught on camera, this car fire slowed down traffic on I-93 South in Hooksett yesterday. The fire closing the right lane for a period of time right near the tolls. Hooksett Fire says everybody in that SUV got out safely. No word yet on what caused the fire. That's it for your morning webcast. We'll have an update at about 1 o'clock this afternoon. Have a great day, everybody.